everybody. My name is David Pegler. This is your pre-London outlook for February the 13th. Happy Friday, everybody. Let me take this opportunity very quickly to welcome you to FX Bootcamp and remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. Myself and none of the other currency coaches are making any trade recommendations during the course of a day. But what I will do is conduct some fundamental and technical analysis, hopefully help put together some good profitable trade plans. Please remember, trading is always very risky business, so do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success on a demo account. All right, well, quick rehash of our trade plan from yesterday for Euro Yen, and then I'm going to move on to Pound Dollar, a little bit of analysis for today. If you remember, we were looking at this 116 level for a breakout, preferably to the downside. You know, we had one little price trap, if I just zoom out for you here really quickly. We had a little price trap here pre-London, and subsequently broke out of it. Well, there were a couple of ways to trade this. There were some minor pullbacks on very short-term charts when we broke this 116 area, and a nice fall. What I traded was this little breakout here that I just pulled a fib of the drop and then shorted this 382 with short-term confirmation to the downside. It wasn't a tremendous amount of pips. I think it was a 50-60 pip trade when it was all said and done. Okay, the other opportunity for this one was a retest of this 116 area, which was a better trade overall during New York. And that one was, you know, the better part of 100 pips when we couldn't close a candle back above that level, you know, and then formed up a lower high on this next candle. I took a little shot, and you know, that one was just short of 100 pip trade. So, you know, all in all, not fantastic trade plans, but really, what do you need? You know, the pound was the shining star yesterday without question, but ultimately, really, what do you need to be successful in the Forex market? You know, providing you can extract, you know, a chunk of pips every day, you don't need a million to make a sound living in this game. So, you know, decent trade plan. Today, let's take a look at pound dollar, seeing that it's been a major mover over the last few days. Let's have a look. We just go to the if we just go to the daily for pound, all right, and I zoom in a little bit here, you'll notice if I take a fib of the whole rise that we run into a 50% area here. You know, we've breached a little bit, but not significantly, whichever you want to call it, 50%, 382. So people that are now bullish on the pound dollar, because if I just get rid of the fib again, you know, going back to in the true theme of this week, going back to the you know, price action lessons, whatever else, all right. If you just take a look at what's happened here, okay, if this is the last swing high and this is the previous low, we now have developed a series of higher highs and what looks to be a higher low than previous. So just on this daily, very short-term chart here, we have the makings of an uptrend. So based on that, I expect there to be some long interest in the pound, almost right where we found it yesterday, right? Around this, you know, 41.20, call it 41.50 area, okay? So, if people have been buying off the bottom for this, all right, remember that the daily looks, from a price action standpoint, somewhat bullish. I'm not outright bullish on the pound by any stretch of the imagination. It's one of the weakest currencies out here these days, okay? But just based on the last, you know, kind of months worth of price action, we are making a series of higher lows and higher highs on the daily. So it's no surprise that we've met some buyers here. Okay, but here's where the fractal nature of the market comes in. And we're going to have to play a little bit of fib wars today, all right? Now, if I just relate it back to the 15-minute, zoom out a little bit, you know, this is, now we started developing a series of higher lows and higher highs at the bottom there, right? So, you know, it's a little lower high here, but, you know, resumed this higher low higher high theme, so an overall little uptrend starting to develop here. Okay, so the lesson is that you can use the short term you know, self similar methodology here to confirm a daily bounce, right? And that's effectively, you know, that's effectively what we've done here. So another question is, you know, another question is, okay, so on the 15 minute we have what is a shortly redefined uptrend, but on the 4 hour on the daily, you know, it's absolutely a downtrend still, okay? A series of lower highs and lower lows, all right? But that doesn't mean to say that we're not going to go up and perhaps make a fib of the overall drop. Okay, if you just look yesterday, all right, on the hourly, we formed up a little 1-2-3 pattern. Remember, what is the definition of a short term of a uptrend, a series of higher lows and higher highs? Well, look here, a low, a higher low, and a higher high relative to the previous. So that, my friends, is bullish in and of itself. So now we have the daily, the 15-minute, and the hourly somewhat looking bullish. Okay, admittedly, we do have some resistance here. No two ways about it. So we now have hesitated here, but if I just put a line at that level, okay, and take a fib of the overall drop, okay, why would I be doing this on an hourly? Because if now that we have a daily bounce, a redefinition of trend on the 15-minute and on the hourly, okay, chances are now we've started the retracement phase of an overall move fib of the whole drop. Okay, now does that mean that we're going to rip to the upside on the daily? No. Okay, it doesn't by itself, but what this does do is more or less confirm to us that we're on our way back to an overall fib of the drop. Plus, we rallied heavily off the bottom yesterday at 70, not 78, but you know, that's 76.50 area for the Dow. Okay, I want to see if there's any sustainability whatsoever in that move, in which case we're going to be selling dollars and selling yen today. All right, so we're going to have to watch how the European equity markets react to late day market movement on the for the US equities yesterday. Okay, but if we can break above this, you know, this 43.20 area, then get a quick pullback, our upside target is absolutely 44.60 to 4,500. Okay, that's our trade. Now, said differently, if we start to form up lower highs and lower lows, yeah, hey, you know, then we are more than likely going to start to produce, you know, some more downside action. Then we're looking to match up the bottom here around this 41.60 area as a target. But that's kind of what I'm looking at. It'll break, retest long to around that 44.50 to 4,500 area for pound dollar today, okay? But, you know, one thing I'm absolutely watching is just a little fib of the rise short term here. If I just relate this to a 15-minute, you know, we've now bounced off the fib. I do not want to see us necessarily start to form up lower highs here, because then it probably means that we're heading back to 40, you know, this 42.35 area, in which case then if we, you know, then I expect to bounce off there again. And if we form up a fib of the drop, you know, a little reverse fib of the drop, well, then pounds coming down again for the day. You know, meaning it does something like this, bounces up and then drops from there. You know, that's our cue that, hey, this topside trade plan's voided and we're heading down probably to around that 41.70 area as a first stop, if not lower. Okay. But once again, you know, keep an eye on your equity market correlations, your commodity correlations, and we'll go from there. Okay. But that's a little trade plan for pound dollar today. Pretty simple stuff. A matter of definition of trend, raw price action, you know, Fibonacci knowledge, and just, you know, looking at the different time frames and trying to relate definition of trend through those time frames. Okay, we are at a 2-hour 21 as I'm speaking to you, but it's almost a perfect overlap with this 43.13 area. All right, this has been your pre-London outlook for February 13th, everybody. Yeah, I hope you have a great weekend, and I will catch up with you Monday. My name is David Pegler. Take it easy, buddy.